Hello, everybody. My name is Bill Bow. I was one of the coaches for JV this year, as well as the goalie coach for JV and varsity.
I'm Jared Ferguson. I was the assistant JV coach for JV and assistant coach for varsity also.
All right, well, we're just going to give you a little rundown on our season went. After trials, looking at our team, I felt really, really confident about where we sat, the players we had, then due to some injuries with varsity and other unforeseen circumstances, we lost a couple of our key players and they got moved up to varsity, which kind of hurt our team as a whole, but it allowed our younger players to get a lot more development and a lot more playing time, which is a good thing. So we started out the season West Fargo, and going into that game, we felt pretty confident. First half went all right, we're plugging the waves. Then the second half hit, and I think it ended up being 4-1. Like, okay, we got a lot more work to do. Season continued on. Won our first game against Central, thinking we're going to be doing all right now. And then after that, we kind of went into a little bit of a rut, losing about 6 games in a row at one point. But on the bright side, every single game except for one team against North, when we played them the second time, we did better than we did the first time we played them. So we beat them after a loss, or we tied them after a loss. So that was a really big achievement for us. We kept getting better and better as the year went on. Players improved very much. But I can't think of one player that didn't get better from where they were at the beginning of the season, which is what you want to see at the JV level. It's not so much about your record, it's about improvement so that they, when they get up to that varsity level, they can compete at the level they need to play at. Another kind of deciding factor was we had a lot of talent. I think talent-wise in the future, our team has a lot more potential. It's just tough when you're 8th graders, 9th graders, sophomores playing against just bigger, faster, stronger juniors and seniors. So when you look out at our team on the pitch, we're a lot smaller than most of the other teams, but tactically wise and down the road in the future, I think our team is going to be a lot better off. Our season, we ended up with a record of 3-8-1 going into the JV Cup, and due to self being the host, we ended up having to play Red River, who was the one seed. We lost to them the first round, and then we lost to West Fargo on the loser side after that. So we ended up being 3-10-2 going into one non-conference game against Chanhassen. With that, our leading goal scorers, we actually had a tie with Braden and Kevin each having 5 goals. So let's have a round of applause. Our leading assist man ended up being Carter Yeager with 4 assists. So with that, we're going to go ahead and go on to participation awards. As we call you up, stand in the line here, come get your award and shake your hand.
Shazen
Ben Maliska.
Before the season started, I had one coach. scramble to get coaches was at all time high, and luckily I got on board and had a special with them this year, which was super fun. And then trials started, which hot weather on the turf, it's the way it is. Going well, and then Roman broke his arm to goal. I was like, oh, okay, well, he's on the side, get hurt equally for most of the season, so that's that. And then after the Jamboree, Wassey hit with the news, oh, I'm transferring to going down to the cities. And I was like, oh, boy, okay, all right. He was kind of a key point to the formation we were going to run, so he had big shoes to fill there. And then I think a couple week or two of the season, Dan broke his arm for his wrist. And I was like, this is how the season's going to go. So, we ended up easy records, 6-8, overall 7-9-1. And doesn't look the greatest, but we kind of just had some unfortunate games. I think we were away, which is kind of weird because of Shanley, usually in the So, Jamboree was all right. So it was a fun thing to do. See who can play. I mean, Tyler, an eighth grader, scored in the Jamboree and was part of the one state. So, that's great exciting stuff. And our first game, takes down and the crossover, 5-0. All right. We can get a little bit lost anyways. We're good. That went well, and then our first game away, it was Fargo, which I never liked. Literally messed up twice, and they scored twice. Just kind of just what happened to play that kind of team. And then the last game of the season against Cheyenne, 4-1 win, just a fun way to end the season on a win, which Shanley usually doesn't do. But last year we got our first win at the state at the end of the season. But better way to end the season than on loss. We scored a total of 31 goals this year. We had 32 against us, so went off. Our leading goal scorer this year was Luke Knott with 12 goals.
So, you know, I remember.
kicked out of the game. So, team spirit, Jordan Brown.
Most likely to gel his hair, RJ.
hate to have to pee. Most likely to ask if anyone is playing Siege tonight. Kevin Gladish.
Most likely to ask if he can play JV, Jason.
Most likely to laugh without smiling. Adam Reynolds. Most likely to be an 8th grader on varsity, Tyler McAllister.
Most likely to only pass to Kevin, Brandon Alter.
Most likely to not stop smiling, Adam Heath. Most likely to walk to practice, Landon Bowden.
Most likely to destroy his own ankle at the most inconvenient time, Jordan Beats.
Most likely to voice crack, Emmett Kenny. Most likely to score all of our goals, Luke Noah.
Most likely to make sure that the ref can count on this.
Most likely to flirt with the managers, Mason Mooney. Most likely to use his feet while playing goalie, Cole Jagger.
Most likely to have girls scream his name during a game, Kyle Stitch.
Most likely to strap a kayak to a Subaru, Kevin Nurse. Most likely to adjust his glasses when he's angry, Ryan Christensen. Most likely to be announced as king, Shawn Michaelson.
And finally, most likely to break his own body, Cam Hoff.
I'll start with the old lads. Usually every year, either the captains or someone from the senior class kind of takes a friend out of the crowd and like, come on, soccer, whatever. And the teacher, JV superstar. But this year, luckily enough, he was straight varsity. So if you couldn't tell by looking at him that he played soccer, you could tell him he was playing soccer. Like, he was a tough guy to take down and didn't want to be in his way. So I had a blast coaching him. Always asking for tips to get better, even though it's just like when you're going here. But yeah, he did awesome for our team, just high intensity, he gave it his all, and he got two goals over this year, which was awesome to see. Another Kai, I don't know. sometimes some moments of just goofiness with the players. Not talking, just when he's playing. Just going crazy. I know him and Jordan have had some crazy battles where someone gets hurt out of it. Same with him and Joe as well. But it was just fun to watch him play. He just gave us his butt nonstop. Cam Hoff, coming up, your sophomore year, and we had Jared Fowler was an excellent goalie. And after you're like, I can't see some growth for here. And then come junior year, Cam grew like a foot and a half, and it was just like, cool, good deal. Right? Don't have to be worried about a goalie. And he did awesome. And then he just got better. If it wasn't for Cam this year, the probably would have scored quite a bit more. And Cam made some awesome saves. I think after each game, the coach would be like, well, great Cam, I've seen here. It's not good for us, I think, but for other teams. But Cam, awesome goalie. I know they've had fun working with you, and I love coaching with you. And then Joe Nicholson. Hard worker, just like that. Just busts his butt, always asking what he can do, all the stuff. There were times where he would scare me half to death. It's just like, sometimes he just whiffed the ball. If it was on his right foot, he almost like whiffed the ball. And so, he started out as a left back. Last year, he started as a left back, and kind of just stayed there. And then last year, the state tournament, he had just, no one got by him. He just had to stay on the performance at state, which is fun to see. And I come this year, the guy I love back, and that's the position blocked out for Joe, whatever. And then we kind of had, I had switched some kids around, and I was Jace back there, and Joe up. And then the first game I did that, Joe gets a goal right away in the first half. And then it's earlier then. And then he scored 2 times after that. So, again, hard worker, and I can count on him, just not be lazy. And then worry about him. And Luke Noah, 4-year starter at RC, started as left back for 2 years. Last year he moved to our center back, and just has been a rock back there. And this year I had him move him up. He kind of played wherever we needed him this year, even if Cam were to get hurt. I know we have good backup goalies, but kind of Luke was there for some days. But yeah, move him up and forward, and obviously it showed that. Formation we ran, we didn't run it how I kind of wanted to go, but it was usually just Luke up there and, all right, Luke, you got the ball, go score. And half the time he did that. So it took a lot out of him, I know. So whenever he got tired of there, I just played defense now, and then someone else would take a spot. So, I mean, these boys, when I came to the program 4 years ago, these guys were freshmen, and then just seeing them grow and improve as players and as gentlemen, it's awesome to see. Always is. But yeah, I just had always had fun coaching these guys and seniors. I don't know what's like a one-time guy. But just getting to know him for 3 months, 4 months was fun. These kids are great. And I'm lucky to have them as my players. So yeah, seniors, thanks for having me here.
Again, players, thanks for coming here. All JV members, come practice every day. say something?
Soccer's just been a huge part of my life since I was in probably kindergarten, first grade, and those little puck nets, and you just get a circle and everybody kicks each other. So leaving the program is really hard, but I'm really glad I got to be in it. I want to say thank you to my parents and my family, the players, coaches, and any administration director, and Al Hager, even though he called me Joey, it's long and thank you. Yeah, it's been a blast, so thank you.
Very well done, Noah. Also, been playing since the 8th year. And thank you, first of all, to my mother for always making sure I'm hungry for games and having meals ready before and after the game. I'm hungry. Thank you to my dad for always supporting me, helping me grow as a player, not just during the season.
That way of measurement is usually
the difficult things to measure, I can discuss a little bit later, but I want to focus on varsity. Ultimately, a coach should be able to improve the players from the beginning of the season till the end of the season. And that's really the most that he or she can do. It's a big job, but what does that mean? Well, if we take a look at some of those things you can measure, Shanley finished 7-9-1. That's the worst record in the past 4 years. But we're not supposed to be comparing teams, just saying, what did you do this year? Okay? So how did this team do from first practice to last game? Now, some of it Ryan's mentioned, but there's 7 conference opponents that Shanley has. In 6 cases, from the first game to the second game, they improved. That is, they either turned the loss into a win, or the goal differential was less, or in some cases, more. Only in case of Red River did they go backwards. They won the first game and lost the second game, or by 1 goal. West Fargo, it was a 6-goal loss to start with, and then became a 4-goal loss. That's improvement. Central went from a 3-goal loss to a 1-goal loss. That's improvement. North went from a 5-goal win to a 7-goal win. That's improvement. Davies went from a 4-goal loss to a 2-goal loss. That's improvement. South, from a 1-goal loss to a 1-goal win. And Cheyenne, from a 2-goal win to a 3-goal win. One of their opponents, a non-conference opponent, Holy Family, finished their season at 17 wins, 2 losses. They didn't mention a tie on the Minnesota State High School League soccer website. And of course, that tie was to Shanley. Their only 2 losses were in Chaska and Edina. They won the 6A region title with 4 wins, having 18 goals scored and only 1 scored against. They tied Shanley 1-1 and beat West Fargo 3-1. They're seeded 5th at state, playing Austin, Minnesota tonight at 7:30. And although Shanley finished at 7-9-1, they finished dead even goals for and goals against, so Ryan and I will have to get together on that 1 goal difference. I'm not sure who's right there. You flip the 3-2 loss at South, or to South at Shanley, and the Deacons are in the state tournament. 1 game. And the Deacons are in it. 7th through 11th graders, this means you can make 2019 season even more memorable. Work out, get involved in club soccer, or at least do some off-season training. That means an awful lot. Up until Hearsville, Devils Lake fielded a high school girls team. And they quit finally because they were tired of losing 10-0, 10-0, 10-0 every game. So club soccer, or at least doing something in the offseason, is very important. And now, as Paul Hart would say, the rest of the story, what really matters? We can measure things like goals and titles and all that. Did my son have fun? If so, thank you, coaches. Is my son a better player? If so, thank the coaches. Is my son a better person? If so, thank the coaches. Was he treated fairly? If so, thank the coaches. Was he a good teammate? If so, give yourself a god of that. And while you're thanking your coaches, thank your son and his teammates, even athletic director or activities director Mike Greger. I'd ask my sons after games and practices, did you have fun? They always said yes. Was the coach good, fair, and respectful? Yes. Okay? Then I would tell them I really had fun watching you play a game. And that's about it. Okay? I think we have the best coaches in the state for high school soccer. There's no other coaches, coaching staff, JV, or varsity, that I would prefer over the coaching staff we have. And I think they deserve it. Putting in that time and effort to make it that way. I watched a little bit of the Kavanaugh confirmation hearings. I was struck by something that the judge said after he felt his reputation was tarnished. The thing that stuck with me is he said he was worried he would never be allowed to coach again. He said that coaching brought him more joy than any activity, even being a judge. So Ryan, thanks for coaching my son Luke for 4 years. Kevin, thanks for jumping in. Dylan and Jared, thanks for coaching Gabe here. I'll bonus speaking for myself. I think a lot of parents in this room feel the same way about you 4 guys. From the first time I saw Ryan emotional after his first state championship game, and you know the championship game. I knew you were invested in the boys. Coaches always don't get the praise or thanks they deserve. I hope, and I know you parents in this room, thank and appreciate all four of our coaches. Thank you.
Thank you.
and has continues to bend and not break.
We have four kicker Shanley though. Excellent opportunity here. We've had some good corner kicks in the past. Corner kicks are you're not going to score on every one of them, but we've had some good opportunities.
It's the young fellow, Drew Bison, a freshman. He gets
it. Nice.
Stepped to defend here.
Well, here's an opportunity. Luke Noah moving in, a little overran the ball a little bit, gets back to it though. Luke Noah curling around, fires one in, and oh man! Luke Noah! How about it?
That is what we talked about with Luke Noah's skill set. You knew it was just a matter of time for you to find a great chance. And from that angle, I have to tell you guys, an absolutely amazing goal to get to wrap his foot around the ball.
Thank you.
Yeah, Trevor said that everyone's not just in every game, though, and coaching's just in every game, so awesome. But yeah, thanks again. Fun season. Parents, thanks again. Coaches. But yeah, thank you guys so much for everything.